Hi guys, this is Ben with FCP. Today, we're working on a 96 Volvo 850. We're going to replace the front and rear O2 sensors. Let's get started. First, you want to come in here. You want to make some room for yourself. The plugs are pretty difficult to get to. So unplug your mass airflow sensor and start removing your intake piping. Also very important while you're in here, you want to remove your PCV system piping. There's a vacuum line on there that'll pull off, as well as your half inch hard line. Pry the intake off your airbox and remove your turbo recirculation hose off the bottom. Also down here, you'll have a plug for the preheater. That needs to come out. Pull the intake piping right out. Set that aside for now. So first, your O2 sensors are these two red plugs here. What we want to do is pry those off of the retaining clips. And using a small flat-bladed screwdriver, insert the tip of the screwdriver into the front of the plug. And as you turn it, they will open up the plug and you can remove the two halves. You want to do that to the second one as well. You want to pay attention to the way this is routed. Behind the heater core lines, if you move those over a little, you'll see right here, there's a clip that goes right into the motor mount bracket. You want to pop that out. Next, grab your 12 millimeter socket, and you're going to remove this plate with these four bolts. Pinch in and push up. Set that aside for now. So what I've done previously to the rear O2 sensor is sprayed it with a penetrating oil. You want to make sure you give that a good amount of time to seep in there and try to break up any rust that is currently locking that in. But I'll give it another squirt, just for good measure. I'm gonna take your O2 sensor wrench, slide it over the wires, and onto the sensor. Once you've broken that loose, you can spin it right out. So we're going to follow along the wiring and make sure we pop the retaining clips out. And these are brittle, so try not to break them. Thank you.
And there's one last clip on the back side of the engine bracket. Use a screwdriver. Pop that right out. You pull the whole harness down. And we'll break free that front O2 sensor. I've sprayed this previously with a penetrating oil, but we'll give it another quick spritz just to be sure. And you could pop your O2 sensor wrench right back over that. Use your 22 millimeter wrench, spin that free. If it seems a little sticky, you can give it another spray. You can tighten and loosen it like this to help work that oil into the threads. So here we have our new OEM Bosch O2 sensors. We'll pull these out. As you can see, really good high quality part, a lot of attention to detail. They give us those retaining clips, and they also give us the markings where the retaining clips are that are under the car. What we'll do is line these up and try to match the length. That way they go in as they came out. During the removal of these old O2 sensors, the retaining clips cracked and broke. But you don't have to worry about that. The new units have brand new clips. They're all in good shape. Everything looks pretty good. New O2 sensor is the right length. And we'll install the new units. Next, pull the cap right off the O2 sensor. It comes from Bosch with anti-seize, so you're ready to thread it right in there. And I thread this in first before I route the wires. That way I can untangle them and have everything be straight before it's electrically plugged in. Tighten this down using your 22 millimeter wrench again. And then final torque using your O2 sensor wrench. Attach the first retaining clip into the plate and then bolt the plate back up. Tighten those back up. Attach your second retaining clip. Make sure they're in firmly. And follow the clips down the line and pop all those in. And as with the rear, the front O2 sensor comes with anti-seize compound right in the threads. So thread that in. Using your 22 millimeter wrench, you can snug that up the rest of the way. You can work the anti-seize into the threads just like when we removed it. And the final torque with your O2 sensor wrench. As with the rear, I left it electrically unplugged, that way you can uncoil the wire if it's been tangled up. Join the front and rear harnesses back together with your retaining clip and start feeding those up in the engine bay. Making sure all clips are secure.
Once you snake the harness up through the engine bay, you'll notice that the O2 sensors are color-coded, a black and a gray. Those go to their associated plug. So pull the red clip out. Insert the O2 sensor plug. It's keyed, it only goes in one way. Push down on the red and that locks it in. Same with the other side. After you've plugged them in, you want to use this clip on the rear of the plug, and that clips right onto its bracket. And same with the other side. After your sensors are all hooked up, you want to put your intake pipe back in. Snake that down. Make sure you plug in your PTC again. Go ahead, snake that around, fit it over your turbocharger. You can pop in your mass airflow sensor section. As well as replacing the hose for the recirculation underneath and your mass airflow sensor plug. Go back down here. Make sure you plug in your half inch PCV hose as well as the PCV vacuum line. Get your flathead screwdriver. Make sure you tighten up your hose clamps. Make sure you tighten up the one down by the turbo. That's it, the Bosch O2 sensor replacement for the front and rear sensors. Again, this is Ben with FCP. If you have any questions, call FCP. Thanks for watching.